My name is Linda Dillon, and I am CEO of Vigilant Care Agency. I'm also a student at Southern University in the Social Work Department. I'm here today to propose a program that will help grandparents guide the moral development of their grandchildren. If you look to the screen, there's a picture. You see the grandparent along with the grandchildren. They look as if they're having a peaceful setting, growing together as they read together. The grandparents seem to be stress-free and enjoying the time that he has with his grandchildren. Well, that's what this program is all about. I'm proposing today that the interaction of both generations are coming together through the program to make a difference in the moral development of toddlers. There is a need. Grandparents raising grandchildren have been on a rise for years. About 10% of the children in the United States are being raised by grandparents. Grandparents are partially or solely responsible for raising grandchildren for various reasons, such as absentee parents, death of a child, to keep the grandchild from getting in the foster system due to the parent's negligence. Because of this, I would like to propose a free program for the community to assist grandparents with raising grandchildren beginning with the age of 4 to 6 years old. This program is concerned with grandparents living in impoverished area of North Baton Rouge, Louisiana, specifically the Scotlandville area. The moral development at this age is very important, and grandparents need the support they can get helping their grandchild during this critical formal years. The project and goals of this program is to assist grandparents by helping them to get resourceful information that can benefit them and their grandchildren in moral development stage by planning activities for the grandparents as well as the grandchildren too. Activities that will help the grandparents to handle any stressors that comes from starting over again in parenting grandchildren. Activities that will give them a place to sit quietly and gather their thoughts while the children are in activity with skilled educators who will help with homework assignments. In order to host this program, another main and immediate goal needs to be obtained through this program, a low-cost, spacious area to accommodate participants. One of our main goals of this program is to make sure that after 12 months of being educated, informed, encouraged, grandparents will have the tools that's necessary to help them build a positive behavior in their toddlers that will cause these children to be successful in any undertaking because of the education that they gain through this program. We will conduct surveys every 6 months to make sure that the grandparents and the grandchildren are learning useful things. I would like to have at least 10 to 15 grandparents participating in this program during the first month meeting. Hopefully, over time, the number will grow and we will have the funding to support a large group of grandparents. All of the goals that I have are specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. I've also considered some activities to get this program started. First of all, I thought about some flyers that we can distribute in the community to let the community know what the program is bringing. Next, I would like to go door to door using volunteers to let those who don't know about the program or who have not received a flyer know that we are in the community and we want to support grandparents. I would also consider putting a letter together and distributing or mailing it out to many of the churches in the community to reach out to volunteers and community leaders for support, to train those who will assist with the program starting and train them in the planning which this program will use to assist grandparents in their quest to shape the behavior of their grandchildren. To get information from the grandparents who are considering our program and want to give us input on what they need from the program. Next, you will look at a video that will help you to understand why I feel this program is necessary.
Them grandkids, they don't want to leave from here. They want to stay here.
My name is Agnes Flores, and I'm raising my grandchildren, and there's five of them from 14 to 2 years old. And I wanted to take care of my grandkids because they're my blood, and I don't want them to separate.
My name is Jimmy Mills, grandfather of these kids that I'm raising. Right now I'm raising two. I'm just trying to do the best I can with the help of God, you know, with these kids, keeping them and bringing them up in the Lord.
And lead us not into temptation.
About 80% of our grandparents and kinship caregivers are not involved through the system, through the Department of Child Safety. Most times they're a very informal relationship where they've just taken care of them for the time being and until something changes.
Well, if you love somebody, you do anything to help them, you know, to try to bring them up.
Most often, they're not in a situation to really provide for a lot of kids, and they do their best, and they would never want them to go into foster care, so they take them in, but it's always a hardship for them.
I also have some evidence-based information. This program would give grandparents the support they lack when raising grandchildren. Many grandparents lack emotional support, financial support, resources, and a community of grandmothers who are in the same similar situations. During this stage of development, children begin to internalize the verbal and nonverbal rules and standards set forth by their caregivers. When caregivers are in a healthy mind, and it really benefits the children in many ways. If the caregiver is less stressed, then they have more patience and more aware that they are setting an example for the grandchildren's morals. This can help improve the grandchildren's behavior and how they deal with their peers and others outside of their homes. One study really shows a great evidence about empowering grandparents who raise their grandchildren. This study conducts many activities that cause the caregivers to give, feel empowered. Activities such as role play, classes of self-esteem, learning to communicate with their grandchildren, and developing advocacy skills all through role play. We would incorporate similar activities in our program since they have been proven to work. In conclusion, many articles show that positive outcomes come from supporting grandparents' programs. However, there are also research that have negative outcomes and would benefit from more support. In many studies, many of the barriers that would be encountered to hinder success would be such as enough participants, lack of transportation, not enough time, or difficulty in finding the low-cost space and quality care volunteers. Also, much like in some of the studies, grandparents might be reluctant to attend for a number of reasons. I'm hoping that they will notice that the positive outcome outweighs the negative. Through learning about what has worked and not has worked in other similar programs, I would like to make sure to put forth a best effort to use proven methods that have worked to make sure my program is successful. I thank you.